We are happy to hear that people are enjoying Sai Pearls of Wisdom and they have an eagerly looking forward for more and more of information periodically from our end. We'll take up this episode that happened on 28th of October 2003. There was a seminar here in Sai Kulwant Hall participated by students of Sri Satya Sai Institute of Higher Learning. This seminar was organized so as to keep the Vice Chancellors informed of what has been going on here at the Institute. We had All India Vice Chancellors Conference here in Prashanthinilayam. Bhagwan wanted students to organize a seminar during one of those days of the conference so that the Vice Chancellors would have some idea of what has been going on here under the divine direction of Swami. This seminar organized by the students had its theme the village project or Grama Seva program. All students presented different perspectives of rural development program, how Swami guided them at every moment. My attempt is to bring your attention some of the highlights conveyed by the students in this seminar. I gave the title Seva Yoga. Seva service, yoga is the spiritual discipline or spiritual path. In other words, to Sai devotees, service is yoga. Service is spiritual discipline. Spiritual path does not mean reciting a name, chanting a name, doing meditation for some time all alone. Not simply that. The most important thing is service. And this service is through yoga. Yoga is spiritual path, spiritual discipline. So service is the path that takes you to Swami. Swami will be very much impressed by your service activity. And then the title of the seminar is Seva and Yoga. Well, what is yoga first? Yoga is the connecting link between the seeker and God. If devotion connects you with God, it is Bhakti Yoga. If wisdom connects you with God, it is Jnana Yoga. If action connects you with God, it is Karma Yoga. If pure love connects you with God, it is Prema Yoga. If meditation establishes link between you and God, it is Dhyana Yoga. So in other words, yoga is the connecting link between the seeker and God. So Seva Yoga, here Seva, the service, is yoga, the connecting link between the one who serves and God over there. And Bhagavan also said, everything is yoga if you offer your services to God. O Lord, let all my actions be pleasing unto Thee. I offer the results of my action to You. If you do that, whatever you do, it is yoga. Then Swami says, work is transformed into worship. With these few words of introduction, the seminar started. I collected some of the excerpts from their presentations and I will be sharing with you the highlights or the summary or the quintessence or the essence of what all they said during their presentations. Actually speaking, all the world over, students are eager to go home for vacation. Usually they go home because they miss their parents, they miss their brothers and sisters, miss their home food, so they would like to go back to their homes during vacation, most necessarily all over the world. But Sri Sachidananda University is very peculiar, is very special in the sense that students don't want to go home during vacation, they want to be with Swami. You may not believe if I say there are students who have never gone home, who have been here for years and years, because they say that Swami is everything for us. So instead of their going, their parents come here, see them now and then and go. That's what is happening. And elsewhere we also find students would like to spend vacation to have some rest, because during the study period they are so busy with their academic work. In vacation they can have some rest. But according to Swami, rest is not relaxation. Rest is not spending time idle. Rest, according to Swami, is change of work. Change of work is rest, according to Baba. Therefore, this year during vacation, Bhagwan blessed them to take up Grama Seva, a rural service program in the neighboring villages around Puttaparthi. So these are not holidays, in other words they are holy days, H-O-L-Y. They are not holidays, they are holy days indeed. And the Vice Chancellor's Conference also was held here from 28th October to 30th of October. And the Vice Chancellor's All India Vice Chancellor's Conference was attended by University Grants Commission, the head of all of the universities at the top level. And many of them participated. They were very much excited and thrilled to see the hostels and students, the classrooms and the laboratories. They were very much thrilled about it, appreciated what all that has been going on here, with the idea that these things I am going to share with you will be of some help to you. I decided to share this information with all our Sai devotees. Bhagavan said long back, when he was at the age of 12, Bhagavan said the following lines in the form of a poem. I'll convey the English version. What is my determination? At the age of 12 he said it. What is my determination? I have determined to spread bliss to the whole of the humanity. That is my determination. Number two, what is the vow that I have undertaken? The vow, the pledge I have undertaken. That is to take those people away from the wrong path in which they have been moving till now. Put them along the right track. You know, people leading their lives in a wrong way, along the wrong path. I pledge to see that they are put on the right path and lead a righteous life from now on. Three, what is it that I love very much? I love to alleviate suffering. I love to see the smiles on poor and needy people by serving them, That's what I like. What is the devotion that you are supposed to have? What kind of devotion should you have? The true devotion is to maintain equal-mindedness both in times of pain and pleasure. This is the substance of the poem which he rendered at the age of 12. See that. So, Bhagwan's life is a message. He is the embodiment of service and selfless love. In fact, Swami has no desire whatsoever. Swami has nothing to achieve because all are His. Nothing is separate from Him. All the property, all the wealth, all the human beings all over the world belong to Him. We belong to Him and He belongs to us. There is no barrier between us. So what is it that He is in want of anything? As He has everything, so He has no desire. And there is nothing to be achieved in life. But the Bhagavad Gita says, Lord Krishna tells Arjuna, look here my boy, I am doing everything, though I don't have to do anything left to myself. I do so that you may follow my example. If I am just relaxed, you will be lazy. I want to set an example to everybody, therefore I do. Though I don't have to achieve anything. I don't have any desires. That's what Lord Krishna said. Now, Bhagavan said clearly, service to man is service to God. And in fact, Swami said, this human body is given to serve the humanity. And in fact, the whole life of Bhagavan is the best example, a best illustration, a continuous saga of giving and forgiving. That's why Swami says, where there is confidence, there is love. Where there is love, there is faith. Where there is faith, there is peace. Where there is peace, there is truth. Where there is truth, there is bliss. Where there is bliss, there is God. So life starts with confidence and ends with the visualization, experience of God. In fact, if we carefully follow a day's schedule in Prasanthinilayam, we see Swami giving darshan, smiling all along, comforting people, consoling people, advising people, granting darshan, very, very busy throughout the day, talking to boys, distributing sweets and fruits. Every moment of his is spent in service to spread joy and bliss to everybody. That is a thing that we have got to emulate in our lives. In fact, Swami's hand or Swami's body does not know what strain is. It has no knowledge of tiresomeness. The physical body of Swami never gets strained or tired in spite of days long work, because His love surpasses, His love excels, His love overtakes the strenuous, tiresome, laborious work that He does day in and day out. In fact, the whole rural development program, such a stupendous, magnificent program, in such a large scale, involving 3,000 students, the whole thing covering 600 villages and 5 towns, that also required 50 lorries, 50 trucks, loads of stuff to be carried to different villages over a week period of time. The whole thing was charted out within 15 days, which is not an easy joke. And the boys could carry truckload of foodstuff, clothes, sometimes by foot, since there was no approach road to certain villages. To some villages had no approach roads. They had to literally carry the foodstuff and clothes all along. And Bhagwan told them clearly, look here, first distribute to poor people first. All poor people, needy people, old people, every member of the family should get the food, prasadam of Swami, and new clothes. And further he said, give knickers and shirts to boys, children, frocks to little girls, and you know dhoti, D-H-O-T-I, that's what villagers wear, elderly people, saris, distribute them to everybody. And he also gave pencils, notebooks to be presented to school children, pens that are to be distributed. Really, it is a beautiful experience for all of the students. And now Bhagavan instructed, they should start from one place with Veda chanting, followed by Nagar Sankirtan throughout the village, and then start distributing prasadam and clothes. The whole village, as a result, is full of resonance of Nama Sankirtan, echoing Baba's name everywhere. This is all full of devotion, sincerity and steadfastness. And boys, in their presentations on the day of the seminar, mentioned certain experiences, the miracles they had, which convinced them that there is an unseen hand of Bhagwan even before they reached the destinations. I'll mention few of them. There is one place, town by name Hindupur, about 2 hours journey from here, Hindupur. There is a colony consisting of weavers there. You know weavers? Weavers colony. The boys went there to distribute prasadam. There they met a very old lady who is staying all alone, away from her children. Nobody to take care of. A tragic thing is, she lost both her sons. Both of them died. She is left with none to fall back. When our boys went there, Swami requested them, please give me a photograph of Swami. And she received prasadam. And then she said to her boys, I have been waiting for this prasadam from this morning. I have been carrying on my life all alone, in spite of the calamities in my family, because of Sai, matchless name. The glorified name of Sai is saving my life till this day. That's what she says. And very interesting is, during that period we had rains here in Prasanthalayam. We had rains all over in the area. Let me tell you, rains did not disturb the work of the boys. They traveled by trucks, they visited all the villages, distributed the prasadam to every member of the family, and rains did not come in their way. That is a miracle. Sometimes the whole sky is clouded. It may rain any time, but it rained after the work, not before and during the work. Why? They commence their work here in the mandir, doing pradakshina around the temple, receiving blessings from Bhagwan. So it can't be otherwise. Nothing, no obstacle, no problems, and the whole project went on very well, excellently. This is the strong, unparalleled, irresistible will of Bhagwan. Another incident, there is a place by name Kadiri, which is about 1 hour drive from here. Near Kadiri there is a small village. Boys went there and tried to give the food and clothes to a person. He said, "Sir, we live in the outskirts of this village. We are Harijans, untouchables. Nobody will come and touch us. So please don't come and touch us. We are untouchables. We live far away from the people. We are cut off from the society, higher class of society. Don't touch us," he said. But boys went, they hugged him and said, "This is not what Baba said to us. Baba said, there's only one caste, the caste of humanity. Baba said, there's only one religion, the religion of love. How can there be anybody who are untouchables? Impossible. No, my brother, please come. We are Baba devotees." That's what they said. And that man was, he couldn't believe what was happening. And he said, "Over generations, we are neglected class of the society. This incident, postgraduate students coming to my hut, shaking hands with me, is enough to convince me that Baba is God." That's what that man has said. In fact, for all of us, it's a matter of revelation to know that this is the effect of Sai message. And then, when they were returning, some of the villagers called boys and said, "You know, Baba loves us very much. Look at that. There is a water tank which was constructed by Bhagwan Baba for us. We get water because water tank gifted to us by Bhagwan Baba." That's what they were telling. "And today, we are getting enough of water every day. This whole area is full of water shortage over years. But now there is no water shortage. Why? Baba's gift of water tank is for the villagers, for the benefit of village. We are the recipients of his love," what they said, with all feelings of gratitude and thankfulness. And some of them have shown them, "Here is a community hall that Baba constructed for these villages. For information, I tell you, in all villages around, either there is a temple or a school or a community hall exclusively constructed by Sri Satya Sai Central Trust under the presidentship of Bhagwan Sri Satya Sai Baba. So all villages, 700 villages, are benefited by Bhagwan service projects." And then, when these boys went to a small hut, they saw a very old lady who didn't have food for 2 days, very hungry. When once they went and gave her food packet, she said, "I do not know how you have come to know I am very hungry. I do not know how you have come to know that I have no food for the last 2 days. God, Bhagwan, knows that I am hungry. He has sent you to pass on this food to me. I am very grateful to him." That's what she said, shedding tears. There is another village by name Karnataka, Nagepalli. Iswarama, the mother of Bhagwan, belongs to that place, Karnataka, Nagepalli. One lady came from a long distance to that village, walking all alone. And she said to her boys, look here, I know that you will be coming today. So I started around 3 o'clock in the early hours. By walk I reached this place. And she was showing them, the sari I am wearing now was presented to me by Bhagwan Baba last year. I have come here again to receive that gift once again by way of a sari which you are sure to give me. So I have come here. And then she says, I got my eyes operated in Baba's hospital, so I am able to see all things clearly. The love of Bhagwan and their love for him, they are really great, unparalleled. And there is one place, as I said, Kadri, 1 hour drive from here. There is a village by name Kotta Ramapuram, a village. And there boys completed their work. And they noticed one lady standing in front of her house, waiting for the boys. Maybe she might have been waiting for the boys for last couple of hours, standing there. Boys came and said, Amma, we gave you prasadam. For whom are you waiting here? And she says, look here, this house where I am staying is newly constructed. You boys have come. I think Baba has sent you. This is Griha Pravesha, our house warming function. If you just put your step into my house, I'll have the feeling that as though Baba visited my house. You are the children of Swami. If you come to my house, I'll have the same feeling that Baba visited my house. That's what she said. And a small house, that's all. A small room and a small kitchen. Very small one, average, poor people. See that happiness. She felt as though the Swami inaugurated her house by requesting the boys to step into their houses. That is really grand. And then she said, boys, the whole house is sanctified now because you are coming from the Puttaparthi. The dust of Puttaparthi which you are carrying along the surface of your feet is dropped here in my room. Yes, that is vibhuti. I am very happy. That is my feeling. That's what that lady said. What a noble thought it is. And then there is one another village by name Subbi Reddy Palli, another village. When these boys are going, school children gathered there. They started shouting, Jai Sai Ram, Jai Sai Ram, Jai Sai Ram. They were jumping all around because they were receiving shirts and knickers, books, pencils, pens from these boys. They were just Sai Ram, Sai Ram, jumping in joy. After all, grown-ups, adults, they could control their joy under pressure. But children, they expressed naturally. That was a wonderful scene for all of our boys. Boys visited another village by name Pedapalli. And they visited one house and tapped the door. A man came. They said, here is prasadam and this is a sari for your wife. That man said, I have got one request to make. They said, what? In the next room my parents are staying. Please give them first and you can give me next. These days, because of urbanization, because of city culture, people seem to have been forgetting the ancient values to give priority to parents. This is one of the effects of modern civilization. Bhagwan says repeatedly, if there is culture still existing, that you will find in villages. So this man said, go to the next room, give to my parents first. then you can pass it on to me. That's what they said. This is the culture of the land. And in the meantime, in another village, one lady came in a wheelchair and she said, that wheelchair, it seems, has got little roof also. She said, this is my house. This is my everything. This wheelchair and the little roof is given to me by Bhagawan. This is my whole property, whole lot. I am so happy. And she says, Bhagawan's love is more than 1,000 mothers' love. Look at me. Though I am helpless, in a wheelchair, I am quite happy because of his blessings. That's what she said. These are all the miracles that boys have experienced during that period of service to villagers. Then, besides this, village service or service in the villages is a kind of practical experience, a sort of training given to our students. Bhagawan wants students to learn service also, not merely the subjects. Anybody can learn subjects, what's all. They should also learn how to serve. It is a new experience. You know, thousands and thousands of people come to Prashanthi Nilayam for every festival, on all important occasions. On those days, earlier, Swami used to distribute saris and also food distribution here in Prashanthi Nilayam. But since the year 2000, Swami started this rural service program exclusively done by the students for the villages at their places, so that they don't have to come all along. This is a new project and this has given a new experience to students. I am also sure that you are fully aware of the fact that girls from Anantapur campus of Swachhanda University start their work at 10 o'clock in the night. The work will go on till 6 in the morning. 10 in the night, it will go on till 6 in the morning. 1,000 girls do that work. What is the work they do? Cooking, packing. At least per day, we needed 25,000 packets. At certain places like towns, we required 75,000 packets. Look at that. So they were doing all that work. How did they do? Singing Baba's name, doing bhajans, start work at 10, that will go until 6 in the morning. It was sight for gods to go there. We do feel like doing it. That's a thrilling experience to everybody. Along with unfoldment of spiritual being in everybody, students also could develop leadership qualities, managerial skills. They could have complete understanding of the rural areas. They could have some idea of social awareness, strategic planning, coordination, all these things they have learnt, which are really practical, very essential for students. It is not enough if they have a degree. Mere degree will make them useless. They should have some training also. So this training that Bhagawan has given has helped in myriad ways. And then this also brought a sort of awareness among the villagers. The boys and teachers, professors, they could see the innocent faces of the villagers. They could also experience the love they have for Swami. They could also watch their devotion to Swami, their feelings of gratitude and thankfulness towards Swami for all the help they received. Finally, they could arrive at a conclusion that the best way to God is only service, and that service should be selfless, and that service should be one of quality and not of quantity. As Bhagavan said, all things happen in our life as a matter of reaction, reflection and resound. If you love, you will be loved. If you serve, you will be served. If you respect, you will be respected. Therefore, everything comes back to you as you do. And then there is one village by name Veerampalli. Veerampalli. There is no approach road to that village. Buses, lorries, trucks cannot reach that place. But some villagers from that village came. They arranged bullock carts for these boys to go there. They could carry foodstuffs and saris in the bullock cart and reach that place, because trucks don't go there. See, it only means there is participation from the villagers also. They are not always at the receiving end. It was a matter of festivity and gaiety and grand celebration during that time. And then, the way how we were all received with smiles by the householders, some have decorated the streets, some have decorated their residences, it is a matter of a grand celebration during that period of time. Bhagavan is the embodiment of goodness and will make everyone good that come close to him. And he will help everybody who wishes to do good to the society. Above all, if we have got a feeling that we are the instruments of Swami, we will be able to do what all that is given to us in all humility, reverence and respect to Swami. And let us also know few aspects from Bhagavan's side. Every day we are all supposed to return by 4 o'clock. Start here around 7 in the morning. Return by 4. We are supposed to eat the same food served to villagers. We are supposed to eat there in the village only. Eat along with the villagers. There is no special food to professors. There is no special food to students. Extra dish for volunteers, nothing of that sort. Swami strictly instructed that all professors, students should eat the same food distributed to villagers, there in the villages only. And after day's work, by the time we return, we find Bhagavan waiting for us with a smiling face. When did you come? How is the day? How are you? When Swami says that, all the tiresomeness, stress, strain, they vanish. And we are fresh. Very fresh. Because Swami's smile energizes people. That is the role of a divine master. In the presence of another human being, we lose our energy. In the presence of the Divine Master, we gain energy. Because that is in response to divine vibrations. So boys are enthusiastic, dynamic, by just smile on the face of Bhagavan. And before they start telling, Swami will look at some group and say, "Oh, you went to that village, good. How is it? Have you met that man? Have you met that man?" He makes a mention of some people there. He turns to another group and says, "Oh, you went to that group. Is that the way there? There are some other villages around that. How do you like the day's work?" He talks to them. Before they have something to say, he starts telling them what all that happened there. This has given a very exciting experience to students, that Swami knows everything, that they are only powerful instruments in his hands, that they have nothing to tell him. that he knows everything, because this is an experience. There's no point in reading a book. There's no point in listening to somebody else's experience. This is a direct experience where Swami tells you what all you have done, including extra sweets that boy has swallowed. Every boy is expected to eat only one laddu. There are some boys who must have eaten three or four or six. Boys are boys after all, you know. Aray, how many have you eaten? 10 at least, I know. Aray boy, 6. Aray boy, you are having still some in your pocket. That is Swami. It is, but he loves them. All I eat, after all, he says, Aray, I love if you eat. I like, come on, eat, does matter. That's what Swami is. And then, there is one boy who made his passport and visa ready to go to America for higher studies. After this Rural Development Service project program, he returns and tells his classmates, I have seen these villages around. There is a lot of service I must do here in this country. There is no point in going abroad. There is no point in being rich myself. I should help my community. And he dropped the proposal, the idea of going abroad. That is the effect of this village service. To sum up, this village program will take us along 3 steps. From I to we, from we to he. I, the individual, we, the community, and he, Bhagwan Baba, the 3 levels that they could experience this. Today in society, we find social service is just a show service, S-H-O-W. But this is real service. We also find some organizations that declare that they are dedicated and committed to service activity. We notice the service is slow service, S-L-O-W. So we find either slow service or show service or no service. But this is the real service. That's what we have done. And Bhagavan says always, you should have concern for your fellow men. You should love your people, because your body teaches you a very good experience. What is the experience of the body? When there is a thorn here in your foot, the hand will come down and will take out the thorn. Is it not? When the leg is hurt, the eye starts shedding tears. It's not the leg that cries. That eye also shares the pain. Similarly, just all the limbs of a body work together in complete coordination, responding in total cooperation. We should learn this lesson from the body. And similarly, work cooperatively, unitedly, offering our services to the community. That's what Bhagavan has said. Therefore, this Rural Development Service is an eye-opener for Sai devotees and Sai students. This is a summary of the presentations made by students on 28th of October in Sai Kulwant Hall, coinciding with the visitory Vice Chancellors, so that all would come to know what all that is happening here by Sai students. That is for the day. This is the summary of the talks given by 3 outstanding Vice Chancellors on 30th of October 2003 in Sai Kulwant Hall. Many Vice Chancellors from all over India attended the conference, and on the concluding day, during the valedictory function, three of them addressed the gathering, sharing their experiences, and I could note down the summary of their speeches, which I wanted to share with you, because as Sai devotees, we'll be quite happy to know what they spoke on that day. This year is the Golden Jubilee year of University Grants Commission, the apex body there in Delhi, which manages all universities present in India. The recognition to universities, the financial assistance to universities, the standard of the universities, all these aspects are controlled by the University Grants Commission. This year is the Golden Jubilee year of the University Grants Commission. The top people from Delhi prayed to Bhagavan, "Swami, we want to have a meeting in the immediate divine presence at your lotus feet, because this coincides with the Golden Jubilee celebration of the University Grants Commission." Our merciful Bhagavan accepted, and so they could have the Vice Chancellor's Conference from 28th to 30th of October. And the following text relates to 30th valedictory function details. The first speaker of the day happened to be one by name V.S. Prasad. He is known at the national level and is in charge of supervisory body that evaluates and assesses the standard of all the universities in this country. He heads an autonomous body which controls the universities. In other words, is a very important person in education, particularly at the university level. And he said few statements which are very interesting that I want to share with you. Quote, "We visited Sri Satya University. We visited colleges affiliated to Sri Satya Sai University. We had been to laboratories. We saw the campuses, the vast stadium. We are also privileged to visit hostels. We could interact with the students and staff members also. We also discussed certain details with the members there in the administration. With all this, we all unanimously feel that visit to Sri Satya University is a privilege and a blessing. This would not have been possible but for the divine grace of Bhagavan. Having been round the campus, having discussed with everybody, we understand the devotion and the duty and the dedication on the part of these professors and teachers working here in this university. We also feel the love of students for Swami, their interest in academics, their standards, we all have understood and observed. We have also had occasion to visit Sri Satya Sai Super Speciality Hospital. There in the hospital we saw old students of Sri Satya University working there as a technician, working in the administration, the paramedical staff and alike. We have observed the employees there in the Super Speciality Hospital practicing all the human values which they studied while they were students here at the institute." That's what they said. we are very much thrilled by listening to the presentations made by students on 28th of October on rural service program so efficiently organized. The apex body in India declares that Sri Satya Sai University is the best of all the universities present in this country. We call it the crest jewel of this country. That's what he said. We also believe that other universities in this country should emulate this best example. It is very necessary. The integrated education which is offered here in Sri Satya Sai University is not present anywhere else in this country. The syllabus and the teaching of the values so nicely blended, so nicely integrated in the regular curriculum and in the regular classroom work is wonderful and exemplary. In fact, there could be a harmony in the society if we have such a size system of education all over the country. And he also said, we meaning Vaishnavas feel that the syllabus adopted by Sri Satya Sai University be followed by the rest of the universities all over the country. We also feel that examination should be conducted on human values and the score must be added while awarding grades to students in their final examination. The environmental science or environmental biology, the way how it is taught in Sri Satya Sai University coupled with human values is the best which we recommend for the rest of the universities. We all humbly pray to Bhagwan Sri Satya Sai Baba that he should agree to start National Institute of Excellence in Education in Human Values, which should be attended by professors from all over the country in batches and trained in the integrated system of education in human values so that they also can follow this university. We pray Bhagwan to bless our efforts and our proposals. Then the second speaker happened to be Professor K. Sudha Rao. She is the Vice Chancellor of the Open University in the state of Karnataka, Mysore. She has made certain important statements which I want to share with you. Quote, Sri Satya Sai University is not merely a university. No. The surroundings, the ambience, the atmosphere is so sacred that every department in this institution, that every student here is an institution for himself. It's not an easy joke. Every student here is an institution for himself. Every department is quite independent. I feel that personality development can only take place in a university of this type, because I feel that integral system of education is the best and exemplary. And not only this, today we find people speak on values. People speak of values everywhere, but they are not practiced. But to my surprise, as I listen to the conversations of students, as I talk to them, as I watch their activities, I say that they are full of values according to Bhagwan Sri Satya Sai Baba. The way he taught them, they are practicing in their daily life. The values are not limited and restricted to books and book reading, no. It is translated to action. it is very much reflected in their daily life, because values which are not practiced are useless. Therefore, there is only one university which stands as a practical example where values are taught and practiced, is this Sri Satya Sai University. And this, there is no other university which is better than this. Swami, we thank you very much for giving us this chance of attending this conference and spending some time at your lotus feet. Now I pass on to the speech made by Professor N. Jayashankaran. He is the Vice Chancellor of Sri Chandra Sekhara Saraswati Vishwa Mahavidyalaya, Kanchipuram, Tamil Nadu. He made a speech which was very well applauded and responded by the congregation that assembled that day. Few points, collection from his talk. Jayashankaran says, in this vast gathering of Sai Kulwant Hall, around 20,000 being present that day, Jayashankaran says, I see in the face of everyone assembled here the face of Bhagwan Sri Satya Sai Baba. The faces of all the congregation are the mirrors where I see the very reflection of Satya Sai Baba. That's what he said. And then Jayashankaran says, I addressed several meetings. I spoke in several gatherings. You must be watching my legs shivering. You must have also noticed me drinking 3 glasses of water because I am nervous. As I feel that I am standing by the side of Bhagwan Sri Satya Sai Baba, I am totally nervous. I don't know what is happening. Therefore, I may not be able to express all that I really want to say. Particularly, I am thrilled by speeches made by students in 4 languages yesterday, the 29th of October. I am telling you all here, please know, none of the vice chancellors who are here can make a speech of the standard of Sai students. The students are better than all of the vice chancellors attended the conference today in their presentations. That's what he said. And he said further, this country is known for excellent speakers, particularly in Tamil Nadu, like Lakshmana Swami Mudaliyar, Ramaswamy Mudaliyar, Right Honorable Srinivasa Shastri, the former president of this country, Dr. S. Radhakrishnan. They are all known for their oratorical skills, their oration. Yes, the students of Satya Sai University are going to be of that order, of that standard. I have not seen till this day students making speeches of that caliber and of that eminence. I have not seen. Let me tell you, the skill, the talent, the articulation, gestures and their content are all the gifts of Bhagwan to those speakers. That is the devotion of students towards the Swami. I want all students of Satya Sai institutions to spread Baba's message all over the country and abroad. And N. Jayashankaran said how he came to Swami for the first time 2 years ago. It seems the daughter of his servant maid had some heart problem. That little girl consulted doctors working in the Apollo Hospital there in Chennai, the former Madras. They said, you need 3 lakhs of rupees to conduct surgery and to give treatment to that girl. She is, after all, the daughter of the servant maid. They are very poor. So they have given up hopes, thinking that that little girl is bound to die, helpless. It was at that time this N. Jayashankaran happened to visit Bangalore on an official duty. Somebody said, why don't you go to Sri Satyasai Baba and request him to do something for the daughter of your servant maid? This man came and sat there, and Baba granted him an interview. There in interview he said, Swami, this is the situation. The daughter of my servant maid needs your intervention, needs your blessing. Please save her life. Baba immediately made a vibhuti for that girl, called Dr. Safaya, the director of Bangalore Super Specialty Hospital, and said, treat this little girl immediately. Do operation. Give all the treatment required totally free of cost, and gave immediate instructions. And he materialized a ring with 3 diamonds to this vice chancellor on that day. And then he said, I paid my debt of gratitude, and this girl got operated there. This had happened 3 years ago, and the girl is hale and healthy and back to normalcy. Doctor said she would not survive for more than 3 months. 3 years passed. She is very fine today. That's what N. Jayakaran said. Further, he made a remark, Swami, the way how vice chancellors are treated here, who attended the conference, I can tell you, we are treated as bridegrooms. A royal treatment is accorded to us. Swami, our visit to this university is not a simple visit. This is a pilgrimage. That's what he said. And further he made a statement, the future leaders of this country, I am sure, will be from Sri Satyasai University. And he observes the serenity, the silence and the calmness that he experienced here is not noticed anywhere. And finally he made a funny statement, Baba, there are 300 universities in this country. We want all the 300 countries, 300 universities in this country to be blessed by you. We wish that all the 300 universities should be like this. For that, we pray that you should take 300 forms and be present in every university so that all 300 universities can be like this university under your divine guidance. That's what he said. And he also made another observation. Nowhere vice chancellors sit for 3 days continuously, participating actively, contributing enthusiastically throughout. Nowhere. Because sometime or other they go to the city, make some purchases, because government pays them money, make some purchases for their family members, go for sightseeing, a break from their routine. They enjoy the place, sightseeing and go. But this conference held at Prashant Nilayam is attended by all the vice chancellors, 100% attendance for all the sessions. This is something unique, that's what he said. People utilized the time in the best way possible. This is the miracle of Baba, that's what he said. That's how that validity function ended that day.